vancha kalpatarubhyascha kripa sindhubhyaivacha patitanam pavanebhyo vaishnavebhyo namo namo mahabadannaya krishna prema pradayate krishnaya krishna chaitanya namne gauratishe gurave gaura chandraya radhikaya tadalaye krishnaya krishna bhaktaya tadabhaktaya yang praprajanta manupetam apelita kritam dvaipayano virakatar yajuhava purseti tanmayataya tarvobhinedu tam sarvabhutaridayam tavai vasmi tavai vasmi najivami tvaya vina iti vikhyai radhitam I'm very happy to come Indonesia, especially Bali.
Jadi saya sangat berbahagia datang ke Indonesia, khususnya di Bali ini.
Pushing some pot. I have come from India.
Saya ini datang dari India.
Especially from Vrindavan.
Yaitu dari Vrindavan.
Vrindavan is a very famous place and very pure place in the whole world.
Vrindavan sebagaimana diketahui adalah suatu tempat yang sangat terkenal dan sangat suci di dunia ini.
I've come to give some messages of Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Kehadiran saya ke sini adalah untuk menyampaikan pesan dari Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhu.
Almost all Indians, they believe that Krishna of Vrindavan is supreme personality of Godhead.
Hampir semua orang India sangat percaya bahwa Krishna yang dari Vrindavan itu adalah merupakan kepribadian Tuhan Yang Maha Esa itu sendiri.
He is ocean of mercy. He is so much powerful. He can create whole world in a moment. He can also destroy whole world in a second. He can do anything he likes.
Beliau itu merupakan samudra kemuliaan. Beliau memiliki kekuatan yang luar biasa. Beliau dapat menciptakan seluruh isi alam semesta ini hanya sekejap dan juga dapat memusnahkannya dalam sedetik. Dia dapat melakukan apa saja.
He appeared in Vrindavan about 5,000 years ago. And he instructed Vedic culture and knowledge.
Beliau,
which is written in Vedas, Upanishads, and all the scriptures of India, like Bhagavatam and others.
Beliau muncul atau hadir di Vrindavan kira-kira 5,000 tahun yang lampau, dan beliau memperkenalkan sistem Weda, sistem pengetahuan Weda yang mana tersirat di dalam kitab-kitab Weda, Srimad Bhagavatam dan sebagainya.
it, you know Mahabharata also. In Mahabharata, there was a very big battle between Pandavas, Arjun, Bhim, Nakulsa, Devati, Yudhishthira, and other party, Duryodhana, their brothers.
Kalian mungkin sudah tahu tentang cerita Mahabharata, di mana mengisahkan peperangan antara Pandawa dan Korawa. Di pihak Pandawa terdiri dari Yudhishthira, Bhima, Arjuna, dan Sakula Sahadewa, sedangkan di Korawa terdiri dari Duryodhana dan saudara-saudaranya.
So no, I think that you know this history because you know all Ramayana and Mahabharata, and you sing in your songs the glorification of Mahabharata and Ramayana. Also, we see so many arts here, like Bhima, Ghatotkaca, and so many things here.
Jadi saya percaya Anda semuanya sudah mengetahui cerita tentang Mahabharata Ramayana itu di sini dan menyanyikannya dengan nyanyian daerah di sini.
When there was beginning battle between them, Arjun told to Krishna, take my chariot in the midst of both armies, and he carried out. And Arjun saw that one side, my all brothers, my so many relatives, their sons, and so many persons were one side, and other side, their cousin brothers, their maternal uncles, Bhisham Pitama, grandfather of both party, guru of both party Dronacharya, and also Kripacharya, and also the son of Dronacharya, all were ready to fight and to give their life.
Nah, dalam permulaan perang Mahabharata itu, Arjuna menyampaikan isi hatinya kepada Krishna. Paduka, ambillah kereta saya. Demikian dalam keadaan seperti itu, di mana Arjuna memandang bahwasanya yang berperang itu adalah semuanya saudara, di masing-masing pihak adalah keluarga, di mana di pihak Korawa diketahui di sana adalah paman-pamannya, guru-gurunya seperti Drona, Kripa, juga anaknya Drona di sana, Salya juga di sana. Jadi semuanya itu adalah keluarga.
Including two parties, more than 20 lakh soldiers were there to fight. Arjun thought that if they are killed, both parties, then all the ladies will be widowed. Chandals will be orphaned, and everything will be upset, and thus religion of all will be destroyed, and thus whole world will be destroyed. So I should not fight for this very little insignificance, wealth or kingdom or anything.
Jadi pada saat itu Arjuna berpikir, ya, di mana ketika itu dua pasukan akan berperang itu sekitar 25.000 laksa dibilang tadi. Nah, itu Arjuna berpikir seandainya mereka itu terbunuh, maka akan banyak sekali para wanita-wanita menjadi janda dan banyak sekali anak-anak menjadi yatim. Dan ini akan merusak keturunan umat manusia di sini, dan juga berarti akan merusak sejarah kemanusiaan di dunia ini. Untuk apa melakukan hal ini hanya untuk sesuatu yang kecil, yang tidak signifikan, sesuatu memperbutkan tentang kekayaan ataupun kerajaan, apa gunanya?
That is why he became so worried and sad, and he left his bow and arrows, and he was lamenting. He told that I cannot fight with my these relatives. I don't want to kill them, only for wealth. And thus he was thinking what to do. He told to Krishna, "Oh Krishna, you are my charioteer, having my reins of my, not only that, I have made my this body's chariot, man's chariot, and everything. I have given the reign of my mind, heart and everything to you. You should decide what should I do. But I don't want. I want to beg in the street like street beggar. But I don't want to quarrel and to kill anyone for only for that."
Jadi karena dirasuki oleh pemikiran seperti itu, Arjuna menjadi bimbang dan seolah-olah lumpuh. Dia lepaskan busur panahnya dan dia tidak berdaya. Lalu dia berkata kepada Krishna, "Krishna, engkau adalah kusir keretaku. Dan bahkan bukan hanya kusir keretaku, tetapi kusir dari diriku, sepenuh jiwaku. Oleh karena itu, kepadamulah aku serahkan segalanya. Apa yang harus aku lakukan? Aku tidak mau berperang hanya untuk kekayaan. Aku lebih baik mengemis di jalan sebagaimana pengemis-pengemis yang lain. Nah sekarang berikanlah aku petunjuk." Demikian Arjuna berkata kepada Krishna.
Krishna saw that Arjuna is lamenting. Then he began to laugh. "How ignorant you are. You are so ignorant that you have left bow and arrow and everything like a coward person. I have never seen a coward like you. And you are thinking yourself that I am so intelligent. But actually you are not intelligent. My question is this, that if you are not going to kill anyone, and you are not killing anyone, but even then they will die or not? Answer me."
Ya, Krishna menyaksikan bahwasanya Arjuna sungguh-sungguh tak berdaya. Kemudian Krishna tertawa terbahak-bahak. "Wahai Arjuna, kenapa kamu begitu bodoh? Kamu melepaskan anak panahmu, melepaskan busur. Sebelumnya aku berpikir bahwa kau adalah orang yang paling cerdas. Tetapi sekarang tidak. Baiklah, seandainya kamu tidak mau berperang dan membunuh mereka, sekarang jawablah pertanyaanku, apakah mereka tidak akan mati, tidak akan terbunuh?" Demikian kata Krishna.
Arjuna began to do like this. Whether I am not killing anyone, or anyone is not killing anyone, but yet all will die. It is true to extent. All will die. Those who will take birth, they must die. Arjuna replied this.
Setelah mendengar pertanyaan Krishna demikian, Arjuna garuk-garuk kepala dan berpikir, "Oh ya, walaupun tidak saya membunuh mereka atau tidak membunuh siapa saja, atau juga semuanya akan mati." Demikian. Akhirnya Arjuna menyatakan jawabannya, "Ya, semuanya akan mati."
So you should also, my request, that you should realize this thing. In this world, we cannot say that God is true or not. But we can tell that one thing is true and death is true. We'll have to die one day.
Ya, oleh karena itu, saya harapkan kamu mengerti. Nah, dalam kehidupan di dunia ini kita tidak bisa mengatakan bahwa Tuhan itu benar atau tidak. Tapi satu hal yang benar adalah kematian. Semua orang akan mati.
Can you tell that I will not die, he will not die, my son will not die, my relatives will not die? Can anyone tell in this world? Never. So death is true. And also one thing is true, that we took birth, then we become child, and after that we become 6 to 8, 10 aged boy, and then gradually we will be up 50, and then reducing. Anyone cannot check old age. The vision of eyes will go, and gradually when we will reach to 80, it will be very hard to walk, to see. We cannot do anything. And at the age of 100 or more something, you must die. We should give up. This is also true.
Adakah orang yang bisa mengatakan kepada saya bahwa saya tidak akan mati, bahwa keluarga saya tidak akan mati, atau teman saya tidak akan mati? Tidak pernah saya mendengar ada orang mengatakan demikian. Jadi kematian itu adalah sesuatu yang mutlak. Dan hal lain lagi yang merupakan kebenaran, bahwasanya seseorang yang telah lahir, di mana dia sebagai bayi, kemudian anak-anak berumur 8-10 tahun, kemudian 15 tahun, dan akhirnya 80 tahun sampai dia tidak bisa dengan kuat berjalan, dan akhirnya melebihi 100 tahun atau selebihnya, dan semuanya akan mati.
Is there anyone here who can raise their hands that I want to be old? Is anyone?
Adakah di sini yang berpikir bahwa saya
wants to be old?
Saya ingin menjadi tua.
Who wants that their hair should be white?
Siapa yang ingin rambutnya menjadi putih?
Who wants that teeth should go away?
Siapa yang ingin giginya rontok?
And he should be crooked like any old lady. Want anyone?
Dan berjalan membungkuk seperti orang yang sudah tua sekali.
But wonderful in this, that Krishna is telling, really, we are out of death and birth, sorrow and suffering, old and all these things. But we, who are you? He is telling to Arjuna, you should know first.
Tapi di sini Krishna menyatakan bahwa kehadiran kita adalah antara kelahiran dan kematian, dan itu disampaikan kepada Arjuna.
Krishna is telling, there are two things. One thing is outer covering. This is made of earth and other things. It takes birth and it becomes old and gives up this body. But really, myself, aham means I. It is out of death and birth.
Beyond.
Beyond. when he forgets his original position, that from he, from where he came, comes. If he forgets these things, then he becomes in the ties of Maya. And then he comes in this body, like a case. And this body is not transcendental. By forgetting Supreme Personality of Godhead, we are now engaged in this body, thinking that I am this body, I am this mind.
Krishna berkata pada Arjuna, kamu harus ingat, kita ini terdiri dari dua bagian. Jadi dua hal ini harus diperhatikan. Yang satu yaitu badan jasmani kita ini yang terbuat dari tanah, dari unsur-unsur Mahabhuta, yang mana nantinya melalui kelahiran kemudian akhirnya mengalami kematian. Tetapi aham, yaitu aku yang sejati, itu berada di luar kelahiran dan kematian. Namun orang yang melupakan kenyataan ini, dia akan terbelit oleh maya ini dan akan mengidentikan dirinya sebagai tubuh ini.
Krishna is telling to Arjun that you understand this philosophy that I am going to kill all. But you cannot kill anybody. And also, you are knowing that there are so many kings like us, they will be killed. But you don't know that before this they were present. And after this death they will be again present there, and even they are. So this body is like Bhashansi Jatha Jatha Vihaya Naman Grihnati Naro Parani Tatha Sarirani Jirnanyani Sanjata Navi Vihye. This body, our body is like clothes. We take, you use new clothes, and after some times it becomes old, torn and old. Then we give up this clothes and take again new. So when, what is the birth? To have a new body is like birth. And to give up the old and to take new, this is birth. And this is death. So you should understand this. If anyone's this body becomes old, he is bound to give up. And then, if he dies, he is bound to take new one. So this is like a chain.
Hey, Krishna berkata, nah sekarang kamu mengerti filosofi bahwa kamu ingin membunuh semuanya, tapi sesungguhnya kamu tidak bisa membunuh siapa-siapa. Tidak bisa membunuh yang sejati itu. Tubuh ini adalah bagaikan pakaian yang mana kita lahir itu berarti kita memakai baju baru, dan kemudian setelah pakaian ini lusuh kemudian kita tanggalkan, itu berarti kita menjalani kematian. Demikian terus berulang-ulang sebagaimana lingkaran. Dan orang-orang ini yang mereka, yang kamu hadapi, dia tidak tahu bahwasanya dulu dia pernah hadir di sini. Dan setelah kematiannya ini, juga dia akan hadir di sini.
You should understand this. Truth, established truth. That we are part and parcel of Godhead. Who is God? G-O-D, the generator of whole world, O operator of whole world, and D, destructor of whole world. He is so powerful. He is full of opulence. He is also so merciful. We are the part and parcels of that Godhead.
Kamu harus mengerti bahwa kebenaran adalah lahir dari kebenaran. Dan kita ini adalah merupakan bagian yang penting dari Tuhan. Apa itu Tuhan? Yang dalam bahasa Inggrisnya adalah God, G-O-D. G itu generator, artinya pencipta alam semesta ini. O, operator, yang berarti melaksanakan dan memelihara alam semesta ini. Dan D, destroyer atau destructor, berarti yang menghancurkan atau memusnahkan isi alam semesta ini. Jadi kita adalah bagian daripada Tuhan itu sendiri.
We must believe in God. Because if there is no God, there will be no creation. Nothing. There cannot be anything without Him. We'll have to at least suppose this. In this world, there are so many controllers, but they cannot control. They cannot make a leg of an ant. So we should think that all the creatures, human beings, demigods, these creepers, trees, everything, they have life and soul. And they are part parcels of the same God. Only that we have forgotten Him, and by this offense, His illusory Maya has captured us and given in jail of this world. So now we are all happy and we are in jail of that Maya.
Jadi kita harus percaya kepada Tuhan. Kalau tidak ada Tuhan, maka tidak mungkin ada ciptaan ini. Memang di dunia ini banyak sekali penguasa-penguasa, tapi sebenarnya mereka tidak berkuasa. Karena mereka tidak bisa menciptakan sebuah kaki semut sekalipun. Jadi Tuhan itu adalah ada dan menciptakan binatang-binatang kecil, tumbuh-tumbuhan, dan di dalamnya ada kehidupan yang merupakan bagian dari Dia. Dan kita yang melupakan kenyataan ini, itu akan terjerat di dalam maya ini.
The God is embodiment of happiness. He has transcendental body, transcendental intelligence. But His body is not material, transcendental body. It cannot be visible by these material eyes. So, Krishna is telling, Nainam chidantri shastrani, nainam dhati tavaka, na chainam kledyam tapo na shosya. Though this soul is here, but not this body. Because when soul gives up this body, we declare that this body is dying. And we see that when a child comes, oh, any soul has taken birth. So this soul is part and parcel of God. He is also very beautiful transcendental body, very good intelligence, transcendental intelligence, very beautiful qualities like God. But as we cannot see that God, that is why we cannot see soul in our body.
Siapa Tuhan itu? Tuhan itu adalah perwujudan kebahagiaan yang tak terbatas. Tuhan itu, tubuhnya itu bersifat transcendental, sangat halus, tidak berupa materi. Dan dinyatakan dalam sloka oleh Krishna, bahwasanya memang roh itu ada di dalam tubuh ini, tetapi kita ini bukanlah tubuh ini. Karena tubuh ini apabila nanti ditinggalkan oleh roh itu dikatakan telah mati. Jadi roh itu adalah merupakan bagian daripada Tuhan itu.
You can tell that. How you can tell that that soul has so many qualities? We can tell it very easily. That what to tell of human bodies? All worms, insects, hawks and pigs, all animals, all trees, creepers, all want happiness. Their nature is this, because they are part and parcel of Godhead, because His embodiment of all ananda, happiness. Jadi, so we are also like this. We are also embodiment of happiness, ananda. We are eternal, but we are infinitesimal, part of that. So we can be covered, but illusory maya, and we have been covered.
Mungkin ada yang
try to understand. This subject is very great. This is called joke. I'm telling about joke. This is Indian joke. And this is really a joke. If you will not know these things, you cannot know what is joke. And then you will think that, oh, this is joke, this is joke, this is. So try to understand. These are the fundamental principles of joke.
Jadi bagaimana kita bisa mengenali bahwasanya roh itu memiliki suatu kualitas yang begitu banyak, ya, dan memiliki suatu kecerdasan. Nah, mari kita lihat bahwasanya tumbuh-tumbuhan, binatang, semua makhluk itu pada hakikatnya adalah menginginkan kebahagiaan yang abadi yang disebut anandam. Dan kita juga manusia sudah pasti menginginkan anandam tersebut. Dan inilah yang harus dipahami, bahwasanya keinginan untuk mencapai anandam itu dan pencapaian anandam itu, itulah yoga yang sebenarnya. Karena Tuhan adalah merupakan perwujudan daripada kebahagiaan sejati itu, anandam. Dan kita bergerak menuju anandam, mencapai anandam, berarti kita telah melakukan yoga yang sebenarnya. Nah, tanpa pemahaman akan hal ini, maka kita tidak akan bisa memahami yoga menurut sistem Weda. Kita akan dibingungkan oleh pengertian-pengertian yang begitu banyak.
So, Krishna is telling that Nainam Chidant Shastrani, any weapon cannot kill show. That weapon can only touch this material body. Also, water cannot touch it, air cannot touch it, fire cannot burn it. And any of the world, anything cannot touch that. Though it is very near here, in our heart, both are here. The jivas, the soul, and also super soul, that is called God, both are here. But we have no transcendental eyes, we cannot see. When a man is going to die, we see that he is dying. But what came out of his body, that he became senseless. We can see. Scientists have done so many things that they should know that what comes from the body and a man dies. But they could not do anything.
Krishna mengatakan bahwasanya roh kita atau atman kita itu tidak bisa dilukai oleh senjata apapun dan tidak akan dipengaruhi oleh api, oleh angin, oleh air, apapun tidak akan bisa mempengaruhinya. Tubuh ini bisa saja hancur oleh senjata, tetapi atman itu tidak. Atman itu ada di dalam diri kita, ada di dalam badan kita, tetapi tidak bisa terpengaruh oleh semua itu.
You are telling that I will kill, but these weapons and you cannot touch by this matter to that Atman soul. How can you touch and how can you kill? These souls is eternal. They cannot be killed. And if you are going to tell that I have killed their bodies, body is always killed. Body has no sense, no intelligence, nothing. It is like earth, air, water, fire, and only. So these are from very beginning, and they will be forever. And so anyone cannot cut them. They cannot touch even what to tell. So you should know that the soul is eternal. It is the part and parcel of Supreme God. So how you can destroy or kill? You cannot.
Krishna berkata kepada Arjuna, kamu katakan, saya akan membunuh, tapi siapa yang akan dibunuh? Atman atau roh ini tidak tersentuh oleh senjata. Bagaimana kamu bisa membunuh? Atman ini bersifat abadi. Kalaupun kamu katakan kamu membunuh badan jasmani ini, tetapi badan jasmani ini memang sudah mati karena dibuat oleh sat-sat mati, yaitu Panca Mahabuddha. Dia tidak memiliki inteligensi. Apa yang harus dibunuh? Itu harus dimengerti bahwasanya atman itu abadi, tidak mungkin dibunuh.
So,
the soul is an eternal part of God.
Jadi atman itu abadi dan atman merupakan bagian daripada Tuhan yang abadi itu sendiri. Jadi Tuhan, atman itu tidak bisa dibunuh oleh siapapun.
Yes, so that again may be fresh and then with fresh mind.
Jai Jai Radha Ramana. Jai Jai Radha Ramana.
Jai Jai Radha.
Krishna again began to tell that there are two kinds of souls. One covered with Maya, that is
conditional
soul, and another out of soul, out of Maya, and they are called liberated soul.
Kemudian lagi Krishna berkata, ada dua kategori Atman atau roh, yaitu yang satu yang diliputi oleh Maya, dan yang kedua adalah yang terbebaskan dari Maya.
All we are in this world, those that don't know what is inside this body, what is so, and how this body is made of. We cannot see anything bad for us. Ever, even our eyes cannot see our own eyes. We cannot see anything. So how we can know who are we and all? And who is the Supreme Personality of God? Who has created? Those who are not knowing all these things, they are conditioned. We are all conditioned. But in conditioned soul, there are so many stages. Some are have some inclination towards God. They want to know God. And those who don't want to know, they are happy in this world, thinking themselves, taking so much wine, flesh, meat, eggs, drinking so much, and they don't care for God, and to know that who am I, and what will be in our future, like donkeys and pigs and hogs, like animals. Animals cannot know them. If you are taken to slaughterhouse, and one by one they are going to be killed in the slaughterhouse, but if some grass is given to them, they will fight for that grass. And that is why today we are fighting for this. We are controllers. We should take this, that, and for this. We are fighting ourselves like animals. One is being hated, another one is fighting with another. Only for this.
Semua kita yang ada di sini tidak mengetahui apa yang ada di dalam diri kita. Walaupun di dalam ini ada roh, tapi kita tidak mengetahuinya. Jangankan mengetahui yang ada di dalam diri kita, apa yang ada di belakang kepala kita atau pada kepala bagian belakang kita, kita tidak tahu. Apa yang ada di kelopak mata kita, kita tidak tahu. Jangankan untuk mengetahui juga orang lain, apa yang ada di dalam diri orang lain. Terlebih-lebih lagi, kita tidak mengetahui tentang Tuhan itu sendiri. Nah, dengan kondisi yang seperti ini, maka berarti kita semua ini adalah Atman yang terbelenggu oleh Maya. Dan orang-orang seperti ini, di mana Atman terbelenggu oleh Maya itu terdiri dari beberapa level. Ada yang sudah menyadari bahwa dirinya ingin mendekat kepada Tuhan, dan ada yang tidak menyadari bahwa dirinya akan menuju Tuhan. Dan mereka itu tetap saja bersenang-senang dengan cara hidupnya, minum alkohol, makan daging, dan makanan-makanan yang tidak berguna lainnya. Dan mereka tidak menyadari bahwa itu merupakan bagian daripada kehidupan masa depannya. Apabila mereka terus demikian, nanti mereka mungkin akan menjadi keledai, jadi kambing, atau binatang-binatang lainnya.
We can make atom bomb hydrogen bomb. So many things. And we can destroy something. But on the other hand, we cannot make a leg of an ant. We cannot create any grass or any creeper, even a leaf of any creeper or anything. We are saying that, oh, anyone can destroy Hiroshima and Kyushu of Japan in a pump. Can they create anyone? Can they give life and soul to any dead body? They can. But there are so many false ego that we are controller of this soul. This is false ego of conditioned soul. So, Krishna is telling that don't have that kind of false ego. You should see that you are part and parcel, mind part and parcel. You are part and parcel of God. You should try to realize all these things. And we all, we should realize. You should not think that only human beings. We have senses. And pigs and hawks and fishes and other animals, they have no life. You should not think. They are a soul like us, but they have done so much wrong things that by God they have given this kind of body to control in jail.
From where is that guy from?
Jadi
karena panjang, dari mana mulainya itu saya lupa. Telah diingatkan, Mar. Ya, manusia itu memiliki kemampuan untuk membuat bom nuklir dan memiliki kemampuan untuk menghancurkan seperti dicontohkan Hiroshima ataupun Nagasaki. Tetapi tidak mampu untuk menciptakan seekor semut pun atau setangkai daun dari tanaman. Namun dengan egonya manusia merasa dirinya super. Ya. Dan Krishna mengingatkan kepada Arjuna, kamu harus menyadari hal ini. Jangan sampai terbelenggu oleh egomu itu, merasa diri super. Yang perlu kamu hayati adalah bahwasanya kamu adalah merupakan bagian daripada Tuhan itu. Jangan sampai dikuasai oleh maya itu. Demikian.
Oke. Krishna began to tell again more something. That in this world, all the conditioned soul, they want to control all. But I know, or we all know, they can destroy our body. They can destroy so many persons, so many animals, as if all the animals had been created by God only to eat them and to be killed. But this is not fact. We want to see in our country that anyone should not be poor and there should be sufficient food stock to eat. But they want to kill animals, fishes, and all for their meat. But they cannot create anything. Only they can finish and they can do all this. But never they can do anything of all this. They cannot create anything.
Nah, orang-orang di mana merupakan atman yang terbelenggu oleh maya itu, setiap orang ingin untuk mengontrol segala sesuatunya, ingin menguasai segala sesuatunya. Dan mereka pikir bahwasanya binatang-binatang, tumbuh-tumbuhan itu diciptakan oleh Tuhan adalah untuk dirinya, untuk dimakan. Itulah sebabnya mereka dengan leluasa menyembelih hewan-hewan.
Now these but conditions show for their happiness. They think that we have advanced in medical science. We have so much advanced in transportation and communication. We have made these aeroplanes. We have discovered computers and so many things. But they should know that have they discovered love and affection for all? This is the life and soul of all. This is the real religion of all. Our constitutional religion. Love and affection.
Sekarang kita telah mencapai kemajuan dalam bidang kedokteran, bidang komunikasi, transportasi. Kita telah bisa menciptakan pesawat-pesawat terbang yang canggih. Semua itu hasil penemuan manusia, penemuan kita. Tapi apakah kita telah menemukan sumber cinta dan kasih sayang bagi semuanya?
Can they change a thief in a religious person? They cannot change even any thief person into religious person. They cannot give love and affection to the persons who are quarreling. They cannot change. But we can change. We can change very easily.
Dapatkah mereka itu mengubah orang-orang yang dikatakan sebagai pencuri untuk menempuh jalan keagamaan? Dapatkah mereka itu menanamkan atau memberikan kasih sayang yang begitu luas? Mereka tidak bisa, tetapi kita bisa. Kita bisa dengan mudah.
Now, twice so much diversion between wife and husband. Why we see that if the children are grown, they are now young, and if they are married, they give up their father and mother. No love and affection for them. And after 2 days, after marriage, even they want to divorce each other. Why these things? We see no love and affection with them. All are self-interested
in their own
self-centered. Yes, like this. Go.
Dan mari kita renungkan, kenapa bisa terjadi perceraian antara suami istri? Dan kemudian juga anak-anak setelah mereka menikah, mereka tidak lagi begitu kuat jalinan kasihnya dengan para orang tuanya. Kenapa itu terjadi? Karena mereka masing-masing memikirkan dirinya sendiri.
If anyone is realizing this, for from any realized person that we are part and parcel of God. By constitution we have love and affection for all. Now we have forgotten this.
Kalau kita menyadari bahwasanya kita adalah merupakan bagian yang tak terpisahkan daripada Tuhan, maka kita akan memancarkan kasih sayang untuk semuanya.
So now we have forgotten that transcendental truth and transcendental God. Those who are realized persons, Krishna sends them time to time in this world to give this transcendental knowledge to all that we are part and parcel of Godhead. God has shape also. We have also shape. We want happiness. Krishna is the embodiment of happiness. And we are part of it. So we should realize this. Go on.
Jadi kesimpulannya tadi itu Tuhan mengirimkan utusannya dari zaman ke zaman agar mengajarkan kepada kita untuk menyadari hakikat kebenaran ini.
Now, if anyone can question that God has no form, because we cannot see. And thus, the soul has no shape. But everywhere it has been told, even in Bible, God created man after his own image. That God created man after his own image. If God has no shape, how he created men of like him?
Nah, sekarang mungkin timbul pertanyaan. Dikatakan bahwa Tuhan itu tidak bisa dilihat karena tidak memiliki wujud atau bentuk. Tapi di mana-mana di kitab suci seperti di Injil juga dikatakan bahwa Tuhan menciptakan alam semesta ini adalah dari imajinasinya. Tapi kalau Tuhan itu dikatakan demikian, sedangkan Tuhan tidak memiliki badan, Bagaimana hal ini bisa terjadi?
Also in Quran Sharif it is written that inna allaha khalaqa man surathi, that Khuda Taala created man as he was beautiful, as his shape was. So Khuda Allah created man after his own, like himself. So also in Quran Sharif there is the word like this.
Di dalam Al-Quran juga dinyatakan bahwa Allah itu menciptakan manusia dari imajinasinya sebagaimana dirinya.
If God has no shape, from where this world came? So many shapes. If he has no shape, from without shape, anything cannot come. From nothing, anything or something or whole thing cannot come. So must be there something. Not something, but whole thing is that. God is whole thing and origin of all world. And he is self.
That is true. That's true. Everything in this world has so many shapes. So God must also have
nothing
shape.
Is we see
because he is the source of everything.
Jadi bagaimana mungkin yang tak berwujud menciptakan alam semesta ini yang begitu banyak sekali wujudnya? Dari sesuatu yang tidak berwujud tidak mungkin menciptakan sesuatu yang berwujud. Dari sesuatu yang tidak ada tidak mungkin menciptakan sesuatu yang ada. Ya. Apakah kita pernah melihat sesuatu ada dari sesuatu yang tidak ada? Tidak pernah.
If there is nothing, then it seems that God is not powerful. He cannot manifest himself in this world. He is so weak, but God is powerful. It has written everywhere. And there are so many steps in him. And from him, all world have come, these shapes. So God has said, and we have also said, but these shapes are transcendental.
Jadi kalau tidak memiliki wujud, tidak mungkin Tuhan itu memiliki kekuatan untuk menciptakan. Dia memiliki kekuatan untuk menciptakan, pasti dia memiliki wujud.
Krishna is now telling that come to this point. Yogasthah Guru Karma. Yogasthah Guru Karma. Yogasthah Guru Karma. He is telling that you should adopt yoga. Why to know all these things? Why we are divorced from God? Now we want to be with him. So there are two things, souls and God. We want that we should meet with God, because without meeting, we cannot be happy.
Krishna menyampaikan kembali kepada Arjuna, kamu harus mengerti kenapa kita merasa terpisah dari Tuhan. Dan kamu harus mengerti bahwa ada Atman dan ada Tuhan. Dan Atman kita harus bertemu dengan Tuhan. Tanpa penyatuan itu, tidak mungkin kita akan merealisasikan kebahagiaan.
If you are put in jail, and you are quite alone for years and years, then you may die. But if there is one another, and who is talking with you very lovely and taking something, also you are enjoying yourself by taking something, talking very lovely, then both can be alive. But if you are put in jail, none is there, you will alone, then you may die. Now here come to this point that Krishna is one thing, Supreme Personality of God is one thing. And we soul, we are forgetting Supreme Personality. They are conditioned soul. These conditioned soul want to be happy, and they do so many exercises for this, but they will never be happy without meeting Krishna.
In jail, if you are alone, you will die.
Nah, jika kamu ditaruh di penjara sendirian bertahun-tahun demikian, kamu mungkin saja akan mati, tidak mendapatkan apa-apa. Tetapi kalau ada orang lain yang diajak bicara dan memberikan makanan, maka kalian akan bisa hidup. Nah, begitu pula halnya kita di sini, tanpa mengalami penyatuan dengan Tuhan, kita tidak akan mengalami kebahagiaan yang abadi. Jadi kita harus menyatukan Atman kita dengan Tuhan melalui yoga.
So what is yoga? One plus one becomes two. This is the theory. One thing is God and another thing is soul. If they are together, then this is yoga. If there is only one thing, then how it will be yoga? There is nothing to add. There must be two things, three things, four things, five things. Then there are things together and they are added, and then it becomes more.
Lalu apa yoga itu? Teorinya, satu tambah satu menjadi dua. Nah, ada Atman, ada Tuhan. Sekarang jadi Tuhan itu satu, Atman itu satu, dan kemudian di dalam yoga keduanya itu bersama-sama akan menemukan kebahagiaan.
Those who are not accepting like this, their yoga is like zero. If there are no two things or more things, how they can be added? They cannot be added. So there are so many innumerous souls. They should be added to Supreme Personality of God. And this is called yoga. A yoga from Atma to Paramatma or soul to super soul. This is yoga. But if there is nothing to add, if God is separateless and soul is also separateless, what is yoga? Zero plus zero, what becomes? No yoga at all. So in this world, all the yogas in name of yoga are really not yoga. Only this is yoga. One soul is added with super soul, then it becomes yoga. Yoga of jeev, soul, and super soul.
Jadi kalau tidak ada penyatuan keduanya itu, dua hal itu, atau beberapa itu, maka tidak bisa dikatakan yoga. Jadi kalau tidak ada penjumlahan itu satu dengan yang lain, tidak bisa dikatakan yoga, itu sama dengan nol. Jadi kita itu, penambahan kita adalah Atman dengan Paramatman. Dari Atman-Atman semua akan bergabung dengan Paramatman. Itulah yoga.
We are doing exercise then, and we are telling that we are doing yoga. What is yoga there? In bodily exercising like this, what is yoga here? What is added? What there are two things. By doing this, by that exercise, nothing is yoga. There must be two things. Well, here what is two things to add? So these are not yogas. And if you are doing anything for soul, but if soul has no shape, and there is nothing, another thing, then there will be no yoga. And if God is alone, shapeless, and there is nothing, then also there is no yoga. So you'll have to come in Gita for to know actually what is yoga.
Nah, ada orang-orang melakukan latihan-latihan fisik tertentu atau gerakan-gerakan fisik tertentu, mengatakan dirinya melakukan yoga. Tapi yoga macam apa itu? Itu bukan yoga, karena tidak ada penyatuan satu dengan satu. Dan juga kita memiliki Atman yang tidak berwujud, tetapi tidak ada yang lainnya yang tidak berwujud itu. Maka tidak mungkin juga ada penyatuan atau ada Tuhan yang tidak berwujud itu. Tetapi tidak ada Atman, juga tidak bisa dikatakan terjadi yoga.
You should understand very easily that there are two bricks. We want to connect them. We'll have to bring mud or cement or so many powerful things to connect them. If we are not keeping only two things, if there are no things, then no connection. If only one thing is there, not another thing, then no yoga. And if there are two things, but there is no masala, masala. Like cement or anything which can add them, then they will not be added. So if you want to add one brick to another, then he should have to use some cement, and it will be like concrete.
Ya, kita juga andaikan ada dua buah batu bata, maka untuk menyatukannya itu diperlukan suatu perekat yang sangat kuat seperti halnya semen atau PC. Ya, tanpa itu, hanya dengan mencakupkan begitu saja, maka ikatannya tidak begitu kuat, akan tidak terjadi penyatuan yang abadi. Juga halnya kalau hanya ada satu bata atau dua bata itu sendiri-sendiri, maka tidak bisa dikatakan sebagai yoga. Jadi kita memerlukan sesuatu perekat yang kuat seperti PC atau semen agar terjadi penyatuan kedua batu bata itu.
So there are two things: creator of this world, master of this world, that is God. And we conditional soul, we are two things. We want to connect them. How we can do? There must be something like cement or anything. And what is that? That is love and affection. As here in this world, any girl, new girl, young girl is connected with any young boy with love and affection. Similarly, we can be connected with that God with love and affection. There is nothing else in this world to connect them. So love and affection is in all. Krishna has given, God has given this thing especially to all. But now we should try to develop out that conscience, that love and affection, beginning from home, charity, from here. And then you should try to transfer that love and affection to creator of this God. And then easily you will be happy forever. Eternally you will be happy.
Sekarang ada dua hal, ada Tuhan dan Atman. Lalu kita ingin menyatukannya. Bagaimana? Nah, dalam hal ini juga diperlukan suatu perekat yang kuat. Perekatnya di sini adalah cinta dan kasih sayang. Seperti halnya seorang wanita tertarik dengan seorang laki-laki, kemudian akhirnya menyatu. Itu mereka disatukan oleh cinta dan kasih sayang mereka. Nah, begitu pula lah kita untuk menyatu dengan Tuhan, maka sarananya adalah atau perekatnya adalah cinta dan kasih sayang itu. Jadi semua kita apabila mengembangkan kasih sayang yang begitu kuat, maka kita akan mencapai dia dan mengalami kebahagiaan itu.
Now it is essential for all living being to collect that cement that is love and affection. It cannot be collected by any wealth or worldly matter. It can be only collected by the name of God. If anyone is chanting, remembering and praying for his mercy, then love and affection that can come, and it can add we all with that transcendental God. There is no other way. So we should try to chant Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna,
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
You can chant any name of God which you like, no harm. But this name is so powerful. It has come from Vedas. And so powerful that it can change a man very soon. And they can have love and affection for God.
Semua kita harus menggali dan mengumpulkan, mendapatkan cinta kasih yang kuat itu sebagai perekat kita. Dan Cinta kasih itu tidak bisa kita dapatkan dengan melalui kekayaan, dengan mengumpulkan kekayaan. Tetapi itu hanya bisa didapatkan dengan menyanyikan nama-nama suci Tuhan. Seperti halnya tadi dinyatakan Hari Krishna, Hari Krishna, 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 Hari Hari, Hari Rama, Hari Rama, Rama Rama, Hari Hari.
Because this God is so attractive, so beautiful, so he is called very charming, like Krishna Deshwar. No partiality, nothing. It has come from India or where, nothing. He is so charming, he is so beautiful, possessing all kinds of transcendental qualities. He is so charming, so he is called Krishna. And he took away all kinds of suffering problems, death and birth. So he is called Hari. And he is so powerful and very beautiful, so he is called Ram. He is everywhere pervading, so he is called Ram. No partiality, nothing. It is for all conditions of a whole world. Hari, Ram, Krishna.
Tuhan itu sangat menarik setiap insan. Begitu cantiknya, begitu indahnya, sehingga semua ciptaannya tertarik menuju kepadanya. Oleh karenanya beliau disebut sebagai Krishna. Dan Tuhan memiliki sifat mengambil semua kesusahan dan dosa-dosa umatnya, dan karenanya beliau disebut sebagai Hari. Dan Tuhan memiliki sesuatu kekuatan yang luar biasa untuk menciptakan seluruh isi alam semesta, dan karenanya diberi gelar Rama.
Now this subject is so grave and deep. I will request you to come also in evening at 5 tomorrow, and day after tomorrow also. We will be only 3-4 days here. So I request your association. Please mercifully come to this place. I want to give my something to you. I also want to take yours. If it is any good thing, I will gladly take it. And if anything mine, beautiful and okay, then you can take it. Reciprocal. So I request you all also to come in more number tomorrow evening.
Topik yang kita bicarakan ini sangat luas sekali, jadi tidak bisa tercakup semuanya dalam kesempatan yang sedikit. Oleh karena itu, diharapkan besok dan lagi 2 hari, mulai jam 5 sore, agar semuanya bisa hadir kembali di sini, dan mungkin mengajak yang lainnya juga lebih banyak di sini. Dan beliau berkata, saya tidak hanya mau memberikan kepada kalian, tetapi juga ingin mendapatkan sesuatu dari kalian. Kalau ada pikiran-pikiran yang baik dari kalian, maka saya akan dengan senang hati menerimanya.
I'm so happy to see you that you are assembled here in about 100 number, not less than 100. So I'm so much inspired to see you and meet you. So tomorrow we will again meet, and I will be happy to meet you. Now we will see.
Hare Krishna, Hare.
Terakhir beliau berkata, saya sangat bahagia sekali bisa hadir di sini dan menyaksikan sekitar 100 orang hadir di sini. Itu merupakan suatu satsang yang luar biasa, dan sampai jumpa besok dan lagi 2 hari kita berbahagia di sini.
I may tell so many beautiful pastimes of Godhead, of him Arjun, also Yudhishthira and Ramayana. I may also tell like this, but
who will tell many stories from Ramayana, Mahabharata, Bhim, Arjuna, Samayana.
Anybody? You can tell something.
Jadi beliau nanti akan bercerita tentang filsafat-filsafat Ramayana, Mahabharata, dan tentang dewa-dewa yang lain.
So before we finish this beautiful speech and this beautiful talk, which our beloved Guru Maharaj has given this evening, we would like to invite you to learn this beautiful chanting of this Maha Mantra Hare Krishna. We will teach this to you.
Jadi sebelum mengakhiri acara ini, maka kami akan senang hati untuk memperkenalkan Maha Mantra yang sangat indah ini kepada Anda.
And it is recommended in this age, this time period that we are living, that if we sing very loudly all together, that this vibration is so powerful, it will purify the whole atmosphere, not only of just this one room, but all of Bali, and even farther than that.
Dan Maha Mantra ini dinyatakan sangat bermanfaat bagi semuanya di zaman ini, karena getarannya itu luar biasa, memiliki kekuatan yang luar biasa. Getarannya itu bukan hanya di ruangan ini saja, tetapi akan ke seluruh Pulau Bali dan bahkan melampauinya.
So we ask you to please repeat. I will tell you how to sing this Maha Mantra.
Jadi awalnya silakan tirukan setelah saya, demikian katanya. Kemudian nanti akan diajarkan bagaimana menyanyikannya.
Please repeat. Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Krishna. Hare
Krishna. Krishna Krishna
Krishna Krishna
Hare Hare
Hare Hare.
Don't be shy, don't be shy.
Jangan malu-malu.
Jangan malu-malu.
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Hare Rama
Rama Rama
Rama Rama
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna
Hare Krishna Hare
Krishna Krishna Hare Hare
Krishna Krishna Hare Hare
Hare Rama Hare Rama
Hare Rama Hare Rama
Rama Rama Hare Hare
Rama Rama Hare Hare
Hare Krishna 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 Hare Hare
Hare Krishna Hare Krishna 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 Hare
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
So they can, I will sing and then they can repeat.
I will sing.
Hare Krishna, Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna.
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare
Hare Hare
Hare Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Hare
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare.
Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Hare Hare.
Hare Krishna, Krishna Krishna, Hare Hare, Hare Rama, Hare Rama, Rama Rama, Hare Hare. Hare Krishna, Hare